Impact Audio presents The Masculinity Manifesto by Ryan Michler, read for you by the author. Dedication. To my beautiful wife, Trisha, my three incredible sons, and my lovely daughter, I will never lose focus and I will never jeopardize my priorities. You are the reason for my work and the fuel for the words found in this book. Introduction. In 2015, I started a fledgling little podcast called Order of Man. Since then, that podcast has been downloaded more than 45 million times, has grown its reach across various social media platforms to more than a million followers, and I can't even count how many men have messaged us with sincere gratitude for the work we've been doing over the past 7 years. But truth be told, I didn't set out to reach millions of men across the world. I didn't set out to record more than 900 episodes as of 2021, over 400 of them with some of the most influential men on the planet. Tim Tebow, Terry Crews, Matthew McConaughey, Jocko Willink, Dave Ramsey, David Goggins, Ben Shapiro, Andy Frisella, Tim Kennedy, Dan Crenshaw, and so many others. No, I started it with much different, more selfish intentions. I simply wanted to learn how to become a more capable man. Period. End of story. Or so I thought. There were men I followed whom I wanted to learn from, but as a relative nobody, very few of those men would give me the time of day, let alone offer me any sort of personalized one-on-one coaching. At the time, I already had a podcast called Wealth Anatomy. It was something I began in order to pick up new clients in my relatively successful financial planning practice. But if I'm being honest, I was getting tired of talking with my clients about money. I would look down at my phone when a client called and dreaded answering it. I really enjoyed the relationships I had with my clients, but I was done talking about investments, insurance, and retirement planning. I figured that since I enjoyed the medium of podcasting, although I was ready for a different type of conversation, maybe I could convince some of the men who inspired me to join me in a recording of a brief conversation. That way, I would get personalized coaching. They would get access to my non-existent audience. Sounds like quite the deal, right? Well, it worked. And since you're listening to a copy of this book, you might have benefited from that humble little podcast that started in 2015. That said, not a day goes by that I don't feel like I'm the greatest recipient of the work my team and I do here. Each day I get to talk with some of the most successful men out there, work closely with the thousands of men who are currently in or have gone through our programs, courses, and events, and interact with you and the rest of the men who are inspired and edified by the work we're doing to reclaim and restore masculinity. Over the past 7 years, I've learned a lot about what it means to be a man. But that sentiment seems to escape a lot of people in modern times. Frequently, I meet anonymous strangers on the interwebs who seem to believe that, quote, any man who has to learn to be a man is no man at all. That isn't true. Not even close. If you're talking about being male, sure, but a man, no. Where being a male is a matter of birthright, being a man is earned. I've spent countless hours talking with others, researching, unpacking, and working towards becoming more of a man myself. Through my work, I've discovered some incredibly powerful concepts regarding masculinity and manliness that modern culture generally rejects. And that's exactly what you're going to find within this book. We're going to explore what masculinity is, what it means to be a man, what men do, and the path to fulfillment for men. Now, inevitably, when I dare attempt to describe masculinity and what it means to be a man, I'm often met with comments like, "What makes you qualified to tell others what it means to be a man?" The simple answer is this: I have a willingness and a desire to do so. That's it. I'm on the path. I've never once asserted that I know more than any other man or that I am the epitome of masculinity. In fact, I'm still very inadequate in many ways. And not too long ago, you'd hardly even recognize me. 13 years ago, I was a shell of the man that I am today. My wife had just left me with our one-year-old son. My financial planning practice was struggling. I was actually very close to throwing in the towel. And I weighed 50 pounds more than I do today. I was broke, mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. It was, without a doubt, the darkest time in my life. Slowly and gradually, I began to pull myself out of the pit of despair I had personally dug. I built a band of brothers. I hired mentors. I listened to every self-help CD and read every self-help book I could get my hands on. Things began to change, and the trajectory I put myself on is what led me to this work. I don't share this with you to beat my chest. I look around and hear from men who are not only hurting mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually, as I was, but struggling at the core with who they are as men. And I can't help but feel an immense sense of obligation to share what I've been blessed to learn. Through my work, I've been able to pull back the curtain, so to speak, to see not only what makes men tick, but what attributes, skills, and characteristics lead them down a path of satisfaction and fulfillment. And isn't this what we're after? I'd contend that we as men are not after happiness, as so many claim. After all, happiness, to me, represents a state of ignorant bliss, free from headache, heartache, and hardship. No, that isn't what we're after. We want to feel useful, productive, and valuable, or what I describe as fulfilled. And fulfillment does not come from the absence of challenge and adversity, happiness, but from the ability to overcome it effectively. In fact, fulfillment can come from some of the most trying times we've ever faced. In 2017, I wrote a book titled Sovereignty, The Battle for the Hearts and Minds of Men. In it, I asserted that in order for a man to be fulfilled, he must first learn to lead himself well. In that book, I articulated the path men need to follow to reclaim their lives and take control of their own destinies. At the time, I saw too many men relinquishing autonomy and control over their lives to their wives or girlfriends, children, employers, and government. While I would still agree that the first step to fulfillment is realizing and harnessing the power a man has over his life, I now see that it's only part of the process. The next evolution is to learn how to take your newly earned sovereignty and turn it outward so that you can effectively lead others well. We, after all, are designed biologically, not societally, to lead. More on that later. Imagine with me for a minute a life in which you as a man have the confidence you've dreamed of. Your wife looks at you with adoration in her eyes. Your children cling to your words and example. They ask for your advice, follow your direction, and live their lives in your footsteps before feeling empowered to create their own. Your employees are honored to work with you and consider it a privilege to learn from you. Your neighbors and acquaintances turn to you for guidance, direction, and assistance. You are loved and valued inside the walls of your home and businesses and within the borders of your neighborhood and community. I can't deny that even I, a man who has dedicated his life to studying and applying masculinity, get a little choked up when I imagine the life I just cast before you. If you're anything like me and that vision for a fulfilled life speaks to you, you're in the right place. You need to know that a fulfilled life isn't some utopian dream available only for a select few. It's available to every man who learns what it takes to make it so. And I'm going to help you do it. Why me, you might ask? Because I know what it's like to live a life that is the antithesis of a fulfilled one. And I know what needs to happen to pull yourself from the depths of despair, or at a minimum, from a deep, unyielding sense of inadequacy. I'm not that special. There's nothing particularly unique about me. I stumble like any man. I've made more mistakes than I care to admit. I've hurt people, even those I love the most, more than I can ever make amends for. In spite of all that, I've built a tremendously fulfilling life for myself and those I care about most. With all that said, if you believe, like me, that the ultimate objective is to live a life of fulfillment, and you can see, at least to some degree, that proper leadership, which is service to others, is the path to get there, the question that begs answering is, how do we then lead more effectively? The answer to that question is the purpose of this book. It's to show you as a husband, father, business owner, community leader, politician, pastor, team leader, project manager, etc., how to foster influence, credibility, and authority, the brickwork of effective leadership, which inevitably leads to a life of fulfillment. But before we get started, what you need to know is that there are forces at work against you. If this were a seamless path, you'd see more men walking on it. You don't, for a reason. There are both external, societal, and internal, emotional factors at play that cause many men to reject the path they're meant to walk, and then ultimately slip into a life of complacency, underperformance, and despair. So to start this journey, we're going to discuss what it means to be a man in the first place. You can't lead others effectively and reach the level of fulfillment you desire if you don't know who you are and who you're meant to be. That's the focus of part one, Bear the Burden. The work of men isn't comfortable or convenient, but anything worth pursuing never is. We'll talk about what makes a man, the archetypes of manliness, and why developing influence, authority, and credibility is crucial to men. In part two, the mindsets of masculine leadership, we'll explore four unique mentalities.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.